Last year was too hot, too cold, too wet,
too dry,
too stormy,
too fiery,
too fast,
too furious.
It seemed worse than usual, kind of like climate change was already happening. Until recently, scientists had been hesitant to link unusual weather to climate change, that far-off phenomenon that would eventually doom us. We could look at how global averages were changing and generally say things like, it's getting warmer. When it came to all the really scary incidents, it was less easy to say, well, that's climate change. Until extreme weather attribution. Basically, it's a brand new field of science that creates models of two worlds, a nice one without climate change, and, well, the one that we have. I'm sorry. Scientists run thousands of simulations in each of these worlds to figure out how frequently a particular extreme weather event might occur.
The analogy that I often use is grass always grows naturally too, always did, but when we use fertilizer on the soil, it grows differently. And so I think these attribution studies are trying to understand how much we're fertilizing this naturally occurring set of weather events with human-induced climate change.
Let's look at some examples. Houston has always had storms and rain, but Hurricane Harvey brought 50 inches of rain over a few days and flooded 80,000 homes across the metro area. That's unprecedented, and climate change was what made that difference. In fact, it made that super intense rainfall roughly 3 times more likely. 2016 saw the highest average temperatures ever recorded, nearly 2 degrees warmer than the rest of the century. Even in an El Nino year, that heat would not have been possible without climate change. In 2015, meteorologists were obsessed with a quote-unquote blob of warm water in the Pacific that killed off lots of fish and starved sea lions and seabirds. A study published by the American Meteorological Society said that without climate change, the blob would not have happened. Climate change doesn't create unusual weather, it just makes it way worse. And in an already monster storm like Harvey or an already warm weather pattern like El Nino, that extra boost can have serious consequences. And though extreme weather attribution is new, that doesn't mean it's not legit.
The National Academy of Sciences published a massive report that validated the field in 2016.
Why does all this matter? This is science that helps frame climate change not as a nebulous future thing, but a right now life-altering thing.
These attribution studies, I think, can kind of bring it home. They make it tangible, they make it local, they make it real, if you will, this otherwise, let's face it, kind of abstract notion of climate change. What I tell people is that, you know, the pointy end of the spear of climate change is severe weather.
A recent Nature study pointed to the importance of being able to attribute extreme weather to climate change. Knowing climate change did this actually gets people to take climate action. Like, for example, Houston Mayor Sylvester Turner, who announced a major change in building requirements to better prepare for future massive Harvey-level floods.
We continue to do the same thing the way we have done it in the past. The rains will continue to flow. Areas and neighborhoods will flood, and we will be in the situation where we are today.
The bad news is, climate change is not just the problem of the people affected by these disasters. It's a problem for all of us. The good news is, if science can make more people realize that, we've got a much better chance of preventing this, or this.